Hey guys, I'm Nate. Welcome back to the workshop. Wargaming has approached us about a sponsorship opportunity to try out their awesome game, World of Tanks. And with that, a chance to do a really cool build that goes along with the game. Here on the workbench, we've got a powerful RC car and a paintball gun, and we are going to see what we can do to combine these two. Our goal for the day is to build a drivable, fireable paintball gun that's decorated to look like a tank. We'll try and get two of these tanks up and running, and then we'll pit them against each other in a remote-controlled paintball battle. We've got our car and we've got our gun. Let's see what it takes to match these two together. First off, we're not going to need the decorative shell that's on top of this RC car. We'll take that off. The basic idea is we will mount our paintball gun onto the body of the car, and then we will build a decorative tank body around the whole thing. However, I think before we get around to mounting the gun onto the car body, we have to be sure that we've figured out a way to fire the gun remotely. I have here a small servo, which I can connect onto the remote control car. That should be able to be activated by the remote control, and at that point, it would make something spin on here, so I need to hook this up to the gun in such a way that when this wheel spins, it pulls the trigger on the gun. Before I attach the servo to the gun, I need to be sure that it can be activated by the electronics in the car. Here we have the inside of the receiver for this remote control car. This is what takes in signals from the controller and makes the car do what you want. This set of wires right here is actually something that controls the onboard audio system. This car will play driving noises as you drive it around. However, we don't need that right now, so we can take this out and plug our servo in. Plug in the battery. All right, now we should at this point be able to turn this switch and have our servo move. Yep, that's moving. So now we know we do have movement out of this thing. We can control it with the remote control. So we should be able to hook that up to pull the trigger on our paintball gun. I think the best bet for where to mount this servo is going to be inside the grip of the paintball gun. So we'll remove the side panels to the grip and see if there's a space where we can get this to stay inside. Oh, beautiful. Okay, I think that's gonna work. I think we can just put the same screw that held the grip on back into the same hole where it came from, but use it to attach the servo to the gun as well. And because it should be pressed up against the body of the gun, when it's pulling against the trigger, the resistance should just push it straight into the body of the gun and hold it in place. That's fantastic. Well, let's attach that screw and see if that's gonna work. Oh my gosh, it's perfect. It's the perfect spot. Look at that. That is attached, that is sturdy. It's kind of right in between the two sides of the handle. Oh, I couldn't have had that work out better if I'd planned it. We have this circle piece, which we might be able to get to work, but the servo came with some other accessories, including this arm. So we can take this circle piece off and replace it with this, and I think that might give us a little bit better leverage because it's a little farther away from our pivot point. So we'll start with it parallel to the trigger. I'm just gonna plug this back into the car for a second. We can see what kind of range of motion we can actually get out of our servo here. Ooh, that should be plenty. So our arm will start right here. When we hit this switch, it moves to there. And then back. Beautiful. All right, well, I think I like that. So let's secure this arm back down onto the servo. I've just got a piece of steel wire, and we're gonna see what happens if we wrap one end of it around the trigger and then wrap another one through one of these holes in our servo arm. Cock this back. Hey, it fired! Oh, and now it slipped off the trigger again. So we definitely need to find a way to make it attach more securely to our trigger. And of course, it's very loosely wrapped around the servo arm as well. But proof of concept, this is working. I think the best way to get our wire to stay permanently attached to the trigger will be to cut a small notch into one side of it. This trigger is made of aluminum and it's at a bit of a weird angle. So we'll bust out the Dremel and just cut a small notch into one side, and that should make it so when the wire is wrapped around it, it can't slide off for farther on. That'll hold a piece of wire from slipping quite nicely. All right, now let's fit the wire into the notch that we cut. All right, here we go. Ha! That seems to be working great. Now we know we can use our radio controller to fire off the gun. We need to find a way to mount this to the body of the car. There's a couple of pieces that I want to move out of the way as well. This right here is the line that lets you connect your compressed air tank onto your gun. but it's not in a very convenient spot for us, so I'm gonna try and move that out of the way, and then we might use an extension hose instead of this piece. Our paintball gun is now stripped down, so there's as little hardware on there as possible, and some of it's going to need to be put back, but I think we should be able to mount the gun right here on the car. There is a threaded hole in the bottom of the handle, and I think we can probably use that as a mounting point to attach it to the back of our car. But that's not gonna be enough support. We're definitely going to need more something holding this gun in place. So I think what we'll try doing is building a frame that connects to these points on the front and back of the car that normally hold the body of the car in place. I've got these two bars of aluminum, and I'm thinking I might be able to cut them down and drill some holes to make them attach to the frame of the car with the same pins that usually hold the body on. Alright, now let's see if these pieces will fit onto our frame. There we go. I think that'll work pretty well. Nice and attached, strong enough, lightweight, excellent. Now we can find a way to add a little bit more support. I'm thinking we'll want a support right under the trigger guard, and then probably something that holds onto the barrel as well. That should give us three different points of support, and I think that'll secure it to the car nicely. Excellent. That'll give pretty good support right there. Now the piece that's gonna support the barrel, I'm really gonna want it to wrap all the way around so it gives side support and up and down support. So I'm gonna try and make a sort of horseshoe shaped piece and then attach a couple of support posts onto that horseshoe shape. Excellent. Let's make one more of those. One right there, one right there. Same idea on the other side. There, one right there. Excellent. All right, our frame to support our paintball gun is basically finished. All we need to do is attach the back of the handle onto the frame of the RC car. I have a machine screw and a nut that will fit down through the bottom of the handle, and then I'll drill a small hole into this part of the frame on the car, and I'll secure it to that. Right, at this point, we should have a drivable car with a paintball gun mounted onto it. You can see the action back here when I hit the switch. Slams forward. Once this is attached to some compressed air and we have our hopper full of paintballs on, this thing should be ready to go. It's not exactly fully automatic firing speeds, but this is supposed to be a tank, and I don't think most tanks have rapid fire. Don't quote me on that. I'm not a tank engineer. We removed the normal hardware for connecting our compressed air tank onto our gun. That came out down here and attached to the bottom of the handle. Since that's not there, we have an extension hose that we're going to use instead. Using this will let us put our air tank pretty much wherever we want, instead of it having to be mounted in just one particular spot. I think I want our compressed air tank to sort of ride on this back bumper section, and then I'll try and add a little access door into the full cosmetic tank so I can take that out and refill it when it's running low. But I have way more hose than is necessary, so I'm just gonna wrap this around the gun. All right, and that still reaches back here quite easily. Good, that's where we want it to come. This is our tank of compressed air that attaches to this thing right here. And so I'll have it rest somewhere on the back of the vehicle. So let's attach this and see how it goes. All right, that is open, so we should now be feeding air into the paintball gun, which means if I fire it, it should actually fire, and now that it has pressure, it should reset itself. Drivable paintball test, here goes. Let's see if we can drive it up. We can drive it back. And most importantly, we can fire it. Ooh, that tore through. Look at that, paint splattered everywhere. That was a great test. The car drives well, it shoots well, and as soon as we have this hopper attached to it, we'll be able to shoot shot after shot. Everything is working great, it's driving well, so now all we need to do is make this look like a tank. I have these EVA foam floor mats, some contact cement, and some razor blades, and that's basically all I'm going to use to build the body of this tank. I have some thinner sheets of EVA foam that are basically the same thing as the floor mats, except, well, thinner. And these won't be part of the main body of the build, but I will use some of this for detail work once I have the general shape of the tank laid out. Now, this is the kind of thing that I wish I could show you an easy way to know how to build a tank out of foam, but really there's a lot of eyeballing it, guesswork, making up measurements on the spot, and a little bit of just hoping things are gonna work out. I have built several things out of this foam before, so I have a good idea of how to cut it and glue it to make it into the shape that I want, but for the most part, it's really just kind of watch what I do. I also have my computer on the workbench with me because I have an image of the tank I'm trying to build up on my desktop, and I'm gonna be referencing that as I build the tank. While we're watching the montage of me building this tank, let's talk about the sponsor that provided this opportunity. World of Tanks is a free online game that throws players into epic tank battles across incredible battlefields. The game is set in the mid-20th century and gives players access to an impressive roster of over 450 authentic tanks. There are over 150 million players worldwide, and they're waiting for you to join. This isn't just a game driving tanks around and blowing stuff up. There are a lot of great game elements to it. Your tank will evolve, your tank can be upgraded and modified to enhance its performance. You can work as a team, you take part in joint operations, you can engage in head-to-head duels that feel like any other co-op shooting game. There are regular updates bringing new content to the game and weekly special events to keep players engaged with evolving experiences. The tanks are true-to-life models and take their vehicle characteristics from the authentic tanks of the time period. For people trying out the game for the first time, we recommend trying the RUIS-3 tank, a close-range brawler that puts you in the middle of the action. The first 300 new users to sign up with the code WW2TANKS will get 3 days of premium time, 500 gold, and a free premium tank. Click the link in the description below and use your code to get started now. There you go, the body of the tank is built. This thing is entirely made out of craft foam and glue. I used contact cement, and I also used a hot glue gun for some of the detail work. Both of them have their different uses, and I think I'm pretty happy with how this thing has turned out. It's fairly lightweight, as you can see, and so far, I have hit it with a heat gun that seals all of the foam up so it will tank paint much better. Then the first layer will be a layer of Plasti-Dip, which is a sort of rubberized coating. Then I'll hit it with primer, and then I'll start with the main color. After the main color is all applied, I'm gonna go in and add a little bit of detail work to get the sort of grungy look that we have in the photo. I'll use a dark brown to give it a little bit of a dirty look, and then I'll use a little bit of silver to make it look like the paint has been worn away and we can see the bare metal underneath in some spots. Bam! Our tank is built, our tank is painted, our tank is mounted on a remote control car with a paintball gun inside, and it seems to me that there's only one thing that it needs. A second tank for it to fight against. We've got two of these bad boys, and in our next video, we're gonna be taking these two out and pitting them against each other. We'll see which one ends up taking more damage and just how much a paintball will do to this floor mat foam that they're built out of. Thanks again to the sponsor of this video, World of Tanks. As a reminder, the first 300 new users for the game using the code WW2TANKS will get 3 days premium playing time, 500 gold, and a free premium tank. Check the link in the description to start playing now. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you're not a subscriber yet, just hit the bomb to get in the club. If you missed our last video or want to see it again, just click up here at the top. Click down there if you want to see what the internet thinks that you should watch next. That's it for now. Have fun, be safe, and see you tomorrow.